Hey everybody, Cyberkai here. As you can tell from the title of this video, I'm taking a different approach and doing a current event. I know some of you with history and civics classes probably hate doing this for your school, but I don't care, I'm doing it for fun. Feel free to use this. Anyways, the current event I'm choosing to do is Phoebe Prince. Phoebe Prince was a 15-year-old girl. She moved to Massachusetts in fall of 2009 from Ireland. Oh yeah, she's Irish. Anyways, in January of 2010, this year, she hung herself. She was targeted, for lack of a better word, by a group of girls in her school called the Mean Girls after she started dating a popular senior football player. She started dating the guy in September. That means from September until she killed herself on January 14th of 2010, she was stalked, harassed, called an Irish slut, a whore, and she had books knocked out of her hands, items thrown at her, her face scribbled out of pictures on school walls, and threatening text messages sent to her cell phone, all during school hours and on school grounds right in front of the faculty. What makes matters worse is that most of the faculty that saw it did absolutely nothing to stop it. The good thing about this, though, is that at least 4 students and 2 faculty members did intervene in the harassment whenever they saw it happening. Now here's the worst thing about this whole situation. Just when school ended, didn't mean the harassment did. She was also harassed and called names on her Twitter, her Facebook, her Craigslist, and her Formspring websites. Now most of you are probably thinking after she killed herself the harassment stopped. It didn't. People who teased her also left her hurtful messages on her Facebook and Twitters after she had killed herself. Since she's died, quite a few memorial pages have been set up in her memory, mainly wishing that she rest in peace, but other ones also advocating the stopping of bullying, cyberbullying, and harassment in schools. Whenever someone dies of unnatural causes, the police are always involved and they always investigate what happened. So, now the police are investigating this, and some people are going to get criminal records before they get their high school diplomas. There are a total of 9 people being charged with Phoebe's death, although not directly with murder, but still being charged nonetheless. 2 boys, 7 girls, all still in high school. There are a bunch of charges being handed out to all these teens, so I'll go ahead and put them on a screen as I list them out. Statutory rape, stalking, violation of civil rights, violation of civil rights with bodily injury resulting, criminal harassment, disturbance of a school assembly, and assault by means of a dangerous weapon. Now, since the students are getting charged, you're probably wondering if the staff, the faculty, or the administrators of the school district are being charged with any felonies. The answer is, they're not. Although their behavior is not criminal, their inactivity is troublesome, authorities said. Now, school officials, since this has made national news, have offered their explanation of how this has all gone about without them knowing. They said they were unaware of Phoebe's situations because she didn't really talk and she kept to herself most of the time. They're also saying very few teachers had anti-bully training, and some accused bullies will not be returning to class. I guess that's a good thing. Let them bully all the time, and no homework. There. Now that you have the facts, I'll give you my opinions starting now. To all of you bullies out there, who the heck do you think you are? Seriously, you're not better than anyone else, so stop thinking you are. I don't care if you were beaten as a kid and you have to take it out on all your little peers. I don't care if mommy and daddy didn't tell you they loved you enough. I don't even care if they spoiled you rotten. You're not better than anyone else, so stop acting like it. To all you parents and teachers out there, if you see something going wrong, do something about it. Grow a set and intervene. It's not that hard to put a stop to something when you are in a position of power. Now it's make-believe time. Has anyone heard of Hammurabi? Has anyone heard of the law code he made? Yeah, didn't think so. Anyways, Hammurabi was the first king to ever write a code of law in human history. To put it simply, the law stated, an eye for an eye, a tooth for a tooth, a life for a life. Now, this is Halo, so guess what make-believe means? Lock and load. All of you in the pit, listen up. You have been deemed as bullies by your fellow classmates. either because you like to knock things out of their hand, you like to throw things at them, or because you like to call them names. Therefore, we are conducting this little experiment. Therefore, we have selected three people that all of you have deemed less important than yourselves to throw things at you. Actually, one thing in particular. The one thing we have selected for them to throw at you are known simply to us as pineapples.
I'm so excited, I'm gonna jizz in my pants.
Are they out of the can or are they straight from the tree?
Actually, the pineapples I'm referring to are M9HEDP fragmentation grenades. The point of this experiment is to see if you like taking whatever you dish out on a daily basis. Throwers, pull the pins, and have fun!